Most respected dear friends, my pranams to you. Today I would like to mention little bit about love jihad, which has been started in Kerala, I think, for the last 2-3 years. The Muslim boys and Muslim girls coming to love affairs with Hindu boys and girls and getting married through threatening or through love affairs, or by persuading, or by sweet and attractive words and action, and finally getting married, and later on through talaq, divorcing the girls and leaving them like orphans in the roads or prostitutes. And as you know that the ultimate aim of the Semitic religion, particularly Christians and Muslims, is to increase their number, either by love affairs marrying the Hindus, or by producing dozens of children, or by converting them by threatening or by persuasion, or through different methods of helping, assisting and providing various types of supports. Remember that ultimate aim of a Muslim and ultimate aim of a Christian is nothing but increase their number. Just like political parties increase their membership for getting votes and also mass support, the Muslims and Christians also do the same. Muslims very rarely try to convert Christians into Muslim fold, and no Christian will ever venture to convert a Muslim into Christian fold. Both of them ultimately aim at converting the Hindus into their fold. There are 1 billion Hindus in the world. Whether it is from Saudi Arabian Mecca church, mosque, or from Pope, they ultimately aim at converting the Hindus into their fold. They know that Hindus have open mind. They think that Hindus can be easily converted into their religion. They think that 1 billion Hindus bringing into the fold of Muslims or in the fold of Christians can get a good mass for them. What they aim through the old Testament in Bible, applicable for Muslims and Christians, they aim at killing the others, those who are worshipping other gods, and bringing them to the fold of Yehovah. That is the ultimate aim. A variety of pathways are opted for converting the Hindus into Christian fold as well as the Muslim fold. Of which, for the last 3 years, the ultimate pathway opted for youngsters directly loving the higher caste or rich or well-known or meritorious or scholarly people or their children, either girls or boys. The girls love Hindu boys, that is happening about 20%, and Muslim boys and Christian boys love Hindu girls about 80%. After their love affair is over, either increase the number of their religion by converting them into Christianity or Islam, or divorcing them through the simplest possible way. And you know that when in Islam, once the talaq is explained, the wife of a Muslim boy, if it is divorced, that girl can go and again marry somebody else. And this marriage in the side of boys and girls can go continuously till the last breath. Many Muslims have got dozens and dozens of wives also. One of the very reputed Muslim leader in Kerala, who expired a few months back, he had married nearly 1 year before his death a young girl, and it did not appear in any of the newspaper. Keralites are also do not know about it. And after the death of that man, this girl can directly go and marry another boy. It is just like animals involving in the sexual affairs. Any boy, any girl can marry any number of boys and girls and divorce and then go on doing this one. I am not telling that all the Muslims are doing like that. I am not telling that all the Christians are doing like that. But when selectively good number of people do it, and another good number of people support it, and a third part of the good number of Muslims and Christians provoke the boys and girls to do so, then the question is that it is a social anarchy which is being created. So my request to each and every Hindu parents, each and every Hindu girls and boys, be careful. Love affairs are not that harmful or serious or deadly poisonous, but you are getting cheated, you are being fooled, you are being provocated, and you are being tortured throughout your future life. So I would very specifically like say, love jihad is a threatening third world war happening in Kerala, and from Kerala it is spreading throughout India, sometimes outside India, about the Indians. So your dear girls, dear youth, my real request to you, if you want to marry a Hindu, let a Hindu marry a Hindu. You know that one, very recently a famous, really literally famous film actor in Kerala, his daughter was involved in a love affair with the son of a great politician. What I mean by great, in quotation, a great politician, and the politician, who is a secular politician, made it very clear that if this marriage should take place, definitely your daughter should get converted into Christianity, then only the marriage will take place. The film actor said, I do not have any objection. Remember that converting into Christianity or converting into Muslim Islam is not a serious, dangerous thing, but that is done by provocating, persuading, by threatening, and by treachery, and by crooked method. The ultimate aim is increasing the number of one Christian and one Muslim. As Mahatma Gandhi and Swami Vivekananda said very clearly, it is not that the number of Hindu decreased by one, it is not that number of Christian or Muslim increased by one when conversion takes place. It is serious that an enemy has been created to Hindu Dharma, to our culture, and to India. That is the problem of this conversion. My request to all youths, be careful. You marry a Hindu, need not be your caste, but a Hindu. Make it sure that he is Hindu also, not by their name, but by their culture and name. And then only marry. Otherwise, it is sad that thousands of Hindu girls are now roaming in Bangladesh as prostitutes through the love jihad. So I request to each and every Hindu girls and Hindu boys, do not get into the trap of Islam and Christianity through this love affairs, which you think it is sacred. They know it is the pathway of treachery and crookedness for converting you into Islam, and just telling the talaq and leaving you on the roads as prostitutes, as the chewed up material thrown into the roadside, like we eat sugar cane. And remember that your future should not be like this, dissolved out. Your future should not be burnt off. Your future is serious for you. It is not the marriage which is serious. If at all you are marrying, that should be sacred, it should be glorious, it should be positive, it should be for loving together, it should be for sharing, caring, and curing together, not merely for sexual satisfaction. And that you should not get involved into the love affairs with the Islam, Islamic background people, and the Christians. And I would like to say, hundreds and thousands of experiences I heard, I am watching every day. That is why I am telling to you, not because I am a strong, staunch Hindu. I do not have anything against Islam. I do not have anything against Christianity. But one section of the people in Islam, one section of the people in Christianity involved in this type of crooked thing exclusively for increasing their number. The one pathway opted is love jihad. Be careful, serious. And both youths and their parents, and the Muslim Christian society, elders, the priests, the religious people, they all take the part of Muslim and Christianity when Hindus are getting provocated and getting married into their fold. So they may be secular outside, they may be no impartial outside, they may talk about Mata Maitri, Mata Sauhardam, the religious harmony, and so on. But everything above the throat, not in the heart. They are all acting like Jesus said, the jackal, the fox with the skin of a god. The fox covered with the skin of the. That is what Jesus also said. Keep the poison of the snake in the mind and show the innocence of the doves and pigeons. So that externally they are all soft and good. Internally they know what to be done for improving, increasing the number in their legion. You should not become a prey for that. My request to you. Thank you very much. My pranams.